What's up, everybody? Welcome back to Team Fish Knuckles YouTube channel. So this week we are playing in the Players Cup 3, and we decided to switch decks. Instead of playing Center Course of the Valley, we are playing ADP, just because I am so scared of Eternatus. I think Eternatus will be like one of the most played decks in that tournament, and yeah, it's not a very good winnable matchup, but ADP does have a good matchup against Eternatus because you have the hammers, you have Mawile, and stuff like that. So we'll see how this deck goes. We'll cover the deck just a little bit. And plus, it's got like all the cards people want to ban. People want to ban ADP for the Altar Creation, where you take an additional prize card and you do 30 more damage. Ultimate does 150. Search for 3 basic energies and a power up your Pokemon on the bench, which is really, really good. You can power up Zacians. Zacians have Brave Blade, which does 230 plus the buff, 260. And now with its new friend, Rusted Sword, you can do 290, which knocks out all the tag teams in the game, which is pretty cool. And that's what makes the deck so good. We have 2 Mawiles in here. Mawile is really good for that Captivating Weak. Once again, against Eternatus, you can Captivating Weak them, put their Crobats on the field, make it where they can't use their abilities or anything like that. Wilybutt is actually really strong as well. It does 10 plus 30 more damage for each of your opponent's bench Pokemon. So they have a bunch of Pokemon. You can Wilybutt for a ton of damage. Big Eater GX. Well, the GX we only care about is going to be Alter Creation GX. It's just because it's really, really good. And that's all the Pokemon here. Cards you could play. I've heard people playing Zamazenta. Also, this is Andrew Wambaugh's list from the Charizard Lounge. Shout out to Andrew for always hooking us up. He's been testing the deck a lot. And he told me to play, and I believed in him. So we, took it for a spin. All right, so what else is in here? Of course, 1 Crobat for that dark asset until you can draw 6 cards in your hand, and 3 Dedenis, because you want to be able to like get that, you know, trying to get that quick turn 1, turn 2 Alter Creation. You're not trying to go for the turn 1. Like, there's no, like, 4 energy switch and stuff like that and, like, a bunch of energy spinners. We're going for, like, turn 1, you get down ADP, get down Zacian, get like 2 energies on the field, and then everybody plays Crushing Hammers. Well, then you have enough energies on the field to counter that, so that is why it's in here. And then 1 Eldegoss, because getting supporter cards like VS Seeker is really, really good, and they basically made VS Seeker an unsearchable card, so why would you not play at least 1 Eldegoss, right? It's a really, really good card. Other things, 3 Cherish Ball to search for your GX cards that can get you the ADP, can get you Dedenne, and get you Mawile GX, pretty good, super consistent. 4 Crushing Hammers, because once again, if you play hammers, if you flip heads, my motto is, if you flip heads and Crushing Hammers, you're gonna win. And if you flip tails, you're gonna lose. It's whoever flips the most hammers win. That's what kind of format we're in, and you'll definitely see that in these videos coming up. It's a big, big thing in these next videos, like who flips hammers wins, and you'll definitely see that in these videos coming up. Energy spinner, just another way to search out the water and metals. It's basically like a 4th water and or a 9th metal energy, just for a consistent factor. 3 energy switch, like I said, everybody's playing hammers. You're playing hammers, they're playing hammers, and energy switch is going to allow you to get that ADP out of nowhere, especially when they discard the energy off the ADP, which is really good. Great catcher is in here because it allows you to bring a GX and EX. Everybody's playing Dedenne. It's worth 3 prize cards, so that the thing is, you play Dedenne, discard your hand, draw, you know, a bunch of cards, then you can, you know, Great Catcher it up. You don't have to use Boss Order that turn, which is really good, and can just help you with consistency and, like, you know, be able to play, like, a Research in Great Catcher or something, and something you can do too, which I do like a lot. Full Metal Saucer, detaching Metal Energy from your Disc Ball to 1 of your bench Metal Pokemon. Once again, it's going to help against Hammers. Also, it's just really good. Like, you don't play 4 Metal Saucer. Like, you have to play 4 Metal Saucer. It's a really, really good card. 4 Quick Ball, can allow you to search for 4. Search for any basic Pokemon. Everybody's a basic. So you have 7 outs to find, like, your Dedenne's ADP in Mawile. So super consistent. You're never not going to find your guys. They're always going to be in your deck, which is pretty cool. 3 switch, of course, want to get guys in the active. Of course, you might want a 4th one because Pikarom and Tandem Shock. Pikarom has seen a very steady decline, and so maybe you don't need as many switch anymore. Tool Scrapper, this is really good against Luke Metal and anything else that plays like Big Charms, because against Luke Metal, you get Tool Scrapper, 1 of the goggles, take a knockout, then you can rest a sword, and then go through 1 of the goggles. So you actually have a really good, decent Luke Metal matchup with this deck, so that's pretty cool to see. 4 Boss Orders, we want to be able to bring up anybody in the field, take a knockout, take those 3 prize cards, be good to go. 1 Marnie, it's kind of interesting. I think we saw like Marnie just a handful of times. I kind of want like 3, Like, maybe cut the energy spinner, maybe cut something else, put three. The thing is, you're trying to fit four hammers in this deck, so you're cutting, like, you know, the fourth energy switch. You could play, like, two more Marnies, and then there's, like, all your hammers are gone, right? But we want to play hammers in here. We want to be able to beat Eternatus pretty well. We want to be able to beat, like other ADP matchups as well, and stuff like that. For research, because it's the best card in the game. Just super consistent to be able to discard your hand and draw seven. Two Air Balloon. The retreat cost of this Pokemon is two or less, which is good because, you know, Zacian has two, Mawon has one, Dedenne has one. ADP has three, which is the only big guy, and then Crobat has one. People give that free retreat's really cool. Slap it early. A lot of people aren't playing Tool Scrappers, so you can, like, Air Balloon one of your guys, switch into it, and be good to go for the rest of the game. Rusted Sword, once again, do an additional 30. Be able to knock on tag teams. Also, you're able to do 260 no matter what, so you can, like, one-shot Pikaroms without the buff if needed, which is pretty cool. Being able to hit 260, I mean, I guess you one shot like all the tag teams, which is good. Like, you can one shot ADPs now, and you can one shot Charizards, and you know, anything. You're just like, all right, Zacian is swinging for 290. What are you gonna do now? Because I just took four prize cards. Like, that's a pretty good thing to do, and then you just knock out anybody on the bench. So that's pretty cool. 8 metal, 3 water. Now, 3 water is always, like, kind of scary, and to this day, like, it's still super scary to me, because you're playing 3 water energies. If you prize, like, 2 and then you discard 1 with hammers, then you're kind of in a bad position. But yeah, this is ADP. It was, like, one of the best decks. It still might be one of the best decks, but it has a steadily decline in online tournaments, but also with online tournaments, you have people just, like, playing for fun and not for serious. So I'm really curious to see what comes out in PC3, because, like, it could be a lot of things. Will Shiny Fakes actually make an impact? I don't think so. I think, like, the only thing you maybe see is, like, a Ditto deck, and that's it. I can't see. The only thing I can see impact is just Rusted Sword, and that's about it. Unless somebody gets, like, really creative with the Ditto V deck. And I'd be really interested to see that, because I know that there's, like, a Ditto V Milotic Rhyperior deck with Welders and stuff. That seems pretty cool. But outside of that, I couldn't think of any other Ditto V decks that there is out there. But yeah, there's Zacian. So this week, we're going to play a couple tournaments with this, right? We're going to see how far we get. The way the PC3 works is if you hit double elimination. So if you lose two games, you're out. And we'll see how far we can make it. Last time we went 0-2, and like we got super destroyed. Like, the games weren't even close. So we'll see how far we make it. Either way, I'm happy we made it to Players Cup 3, because a lot of players didn't make it. I think there was like only 200 and something people that made it. 236 people registered, so whatever that is. I think there was like, I don't know, thousands and thousands of people playing on Leaderbirds, which is crazy. That's how big Pokemon is now. But yeah, hope you enjoyed the video. I know today is just a breakdown of ADP, but for the remainder of the week, we'll have Players Cup 3, and then we'll see if we'll play next Saturday's tournament or not. Alright guys, hope you enjoyed the video. Thanks for watching. Hit that subscribe button. We'll see you tomorrow. Alrighty. Bye.